Hey everybody, this is graphic designer Roberto Blake, and in today's YouTube video, I'm going to talk about how you get a graphic design internship. So a lot of you on the channel have actually been asking this question quite a lot, so I wanted to cover it in this video. Now, I didn't do a graphic design internship. I actually did a formal apprenticeship with my photography professor when I was doing graphic design courses. So what I really got into with the photography stuff was a lot of the composition and the lighting. And, you know, I really had a lot of questions. I was constantly bugging my professor about this. And eventually, I actually convinced him to take me on as an apprentice. So I ended up learning a whole lot of stuff that was really interesting and that I might not have learned in the classroom. And I ended up seeing what it was really like and getting the experience by doing photo shoots with somebody who really understood it and had done it before for a living. So that was what was really cool about it. Now, in regard to a graphic design internship, you should be looking for exactly pretty much the same kind of experience. You should be looking at on-the-job learning, finding out what the realities of it are, what the most used skills within your field are, and I can tell you a little bit about that from actually having worked in the field, which is what other people will be doing if they're your mentors in an internship. You know, they'll be getting hands-on with you and showing you that this is the way we actually do it in the industry, and this is what's different from what you've been learning in school, or did your school cover this? Did your professors tell you about XYZ? A lot of it will actually focus probably on the day-to-day business of the industry, working with clients, pitching clients, following up with clients, the whole client services relationship thing. But let's get back into how you actually land an internship. This is where your personal skills and networking capabilities are really going to come in handy here. If you can build a good relationship with your professors, they're going to be essential to placing you in good internships because they already have those contacts for internships or for work study or even for apprenticeships. And if you have a good relationship with them and if you ask them about it, then you're more likely to actually get one and they'll help you prepare and do everything you need to. You're going to want to make sure that you have a portfolio. You're going to want to make sure that you have a resume, even if it's going to be sparse. You want to make sure that you have a business card so that they can see you're taking this seriously and you're professional. If you don't have the money to get really good business cards, which they're really cheap if you go to like gotprint.com, again, this is not a like plug for them. I use them all the time. It's why I got my business cards, so that's why I'm recommending them. But you can go there and you get like 1,000 business cards, front and back, glossy, colored for like $28, which is probably gonna be a better deal than your local print shop can provide. So go ahead and have that, be able to show them that, hey, you're a serious graphic designer, you have a business card, it's well laid out, it shows good typography choices, conveys the information they need, same thing with your portfolio, and that you're really eager and willing to learn, have that resume in hand to give to them, and be prepared to do a formal interview just like you would for a regular job. You know, don't take it for granted that your professor recommended you and think that this is a lock and that you don't have to take it seriously. Consider this as an interview for a regular job that you'd be getting and take it that seriously. Go ahead and make sure that you're dressed appropriately. If you're a guy, that means probably shirt and tie, if not suit and tie. If you're a young lady, then that means wear tasteful business attire, whatever that might mean for you and for your body type. And just make sure you're doing everything you can to have a professional appearance across the board, both with you personally and with your portfolio and body of work. If you can't get an internship directly through your school or your professor, you might be able to do it on your own. You'll want to go online to various different job sites. I will leave design job site links in the description below where you can properly find these internships, and that's where you'll want to look. There are companies looking for interns all the time, so don't be afraid to reach out to them directly, even if you don't have a referral or a reference to them. Also, make sure that you're reaching out to people that you know. Reach out to friends of family members or of other students and see if they have the need for a graphic designer with regard to an internship or outrightly for just a starting entry-level position. Ideally, your internship will turn into a paying job or at least will be a good reference for a paying job, but you might be able to skip this process altogether, get a paying job, and learn on the job as you go. That's really what actually ended up happening to me with regard to graphic design. I ended up getting a job as a web designer, so I learned a lot on the job, and I was freelancing already before that. But it was just a different type of environment working as an in-house designer, and I gained a ton of experience as a result, and then from there I went on to work at an ad agency, etc. So that's probably what you'll want to try to do. You'll probably want to try and use all of your contacts, any connections you have, to try and get an internship. If that's not working out for you, go online and apply to as many different places as you can. I highly recommend that if you're away from home from school and you actually are in a metro area or a city, that you apply for internships while you're in school and in that metro area, because it'll be easier for you to gain that access. If you live in a small town, it's gonna be a lot more difficult for you, and there are gonna be a lot less places willing to take you on, but you might be able to get in at a print shop or something. So definitely try and find places that might use your skills. Try and see if you can find office buildings that might have a need of your skills. Try and see if you can find a print shop or anything like that. See if there's a local marketing firm, and just try and see if you can get in there. But you're gonna have a much easier time, and I'll do a whole video on where you should look at possibly living or going to school if you're a graphic designer. But if you're in a metro area or a city, you're gonna have an easier time getting an internship. You're also gonna have an easier time finding jobs. Well, I hope this video was helpful for you. I hope it answers your questions as to how you get an internship. If you don't feel that I covered anything or you have suggestions, please leave that stuff in the comment section below and I'll try and answer it as best as I can. Like this video if you like it. Don't forget to subscribe. Check out the other graphic design videos on my channel. And as always, thanks for watching.